It's that time of year. Everyone at Jay Peak Resort in Vermont is gearing up for the ski season. But for co-owner Bill Stanger, the snow's not enough to make a business. He's hard at work transforming the winter resort into a year-round facility, building a golf course, a water park, and an indoor ice rink.
Without sustained year-round operations, you can't survive. You must be 12-month-a-year operation.
You can see the snow guns over there from here.
He needed about $250 million to expand, but banks wanted 30% down, money he did not have.
If you don't have capital, you can't make things happen.
Instead, using a federal program, Stanger got the money from rich immigrants willing to invest $500,000 each in exchange for a green card for them and their families.
We have over 500 investors from 56 countries.
Among them, Barinda Bular and his wife, Roshni.
These are the permanent green cards.
These are the permanent green cards.
Bular is an Indian engineer who often traveled on business to the United States. He decided to switch countries and careers and became a mystic teaching enlightenment.
I made up my mind, I'll come here. And the only option available at that time was the investor route.
The 20-year-old program, known as EB-5, has brought in about $2 billion in investment and has been aggressively promoted by the Obama administration as a way to create jobs, especially in rural areas with high unemployment. Critics like David North, who supports strict limits on immigration, says this amounts to selling green cards on the cheap.
If we are going to be selling visas for money, I think we should sell them for a lot more and put the money in the Treasury. Rather than scattering it around for these developers who have figured out how to get money from the aliens.
Tell that to Bill Stanger.
A conference center. We have retail shops.
Eager to show us around and boast of the impact on the local economy.
Hundreds and hundreds of new full-time jobs being created as a result of these facilities.
Locals also are happy for the foreign investment. Employee Brad Quinton has been able to stay put and raise his family here.
Before this started, I was traveling 2, 3, 4 hours to work, to Connecticut, to New Hampshire.
And now year-round employee Alex Knofts says the pros outweigh the cons.
We're looking at a few thousand people coming in and creating a whole bunch of jobs for those of us that need them quite badly.
Deborah Feyerick, CNN.